Al-Kadosh, Shavua Tov, Erev Tov, Tzahoraim Tovim. Mesechet Ta'anit. Yeah, Tarte Desas. No, for us, it's okay. We do it properly. Right? We do Mesechet Ta'anit of Zayin Udalek, 71. Second line. The second line says, Amar Rabbi Avhu. Says Rabbi Avhu. Gadol Yom HaGeshamim Mitchiyat HaMetim. Yeah? Yom HaGeshamim is greater than Tchiyat HaMetim. What I'm trying to say now is that Geshamim is greater than Tchiyat HaMetim. Why? Deilu Tchiyat HaMetim. Because Tchiyat HaMetim is good La Sadikim. ואילו רשעים בין לצדיקים ובין לרשעים. So basically, what is it saying over here? Why is it that Geshamim is greater than Tchiyat HaMetim? Because Tchiyat HaMetim is only for tzadik. A tzadik comes back alive. The rishayim, they stay 6 feet under. They stay 6 feet under. But to do with Geshamim, it's bein lerishayim, bein lasadikim. Now, so what's greater? Geshamim or Geshamim or, okay? Upliga de Rav Yosef. But this argues on Rav Yosef. Why does it argue on Rav Yosef? The Amar Rav Yosef, it says Rav Yosef, mitoch sheyish shekula ketriyat ametim, since it's equal to techiyat ametim, shekula shakul, just like we have. Moshe ve'Aaron, they were shikulim. Shikulim means they're equal. So he said, kavua betchiyat hametim. So they instituted geshamim in techiyat hametim. So you see from here that it's a machloke between Rav Yosef and Rabbi Avhu. One more time. Machloke between Rav Yosef, right, and Rabbi Avhu. According to Rabbi Avhu, what is greater? Geshamim is greater than Tchiyat HaMetim. According to Rav Yosef, no, they're both equal. It was a trick question. They're both equal. One more time. Nobody's with me. One more time. Come out of Yehuda, says of Yehuda, Gadol Yom HaGeshamim Kayom Shenitna Bo Torah. Are you guys listening? It's so great, right? The day of the Geshamim, just like the day that was given the Torah. Shneimad, as it says in a pasuk, Ya'arov kamatal ufi, tazal kadal inati, ve'en leka, el la Torah. Shneimad, ki leka Torah. Natati lachem. What does that mean? For the rabbi is saying that Geshamim is so great, just like the day of the giving of the Torah. The day of the giving of the Torah, right? We say Yarov Kumatal Ifi, that it was giving the Torah, was a lekach of the Torah. So just like the lekach of the Torah, now we know from Kilek Torah, so therefore Moshe Rabbeinu is making equal. He's equating the Luda Torah to Yiritat Geshamim. And when a person comes and they're learning Torah, it's like Pashut, it's like that they're bringing, right, Geshamim. Okay, now, right, what does that mean now? That just like Geshem brings Chayim La'olam, so too the Torah brings Chayim La'olam. Meaning, what brings life? You think a croissant is going to bring life? Yeah? Or the salt and the salt and the croissant and the croissant. He was talking about all the croissants on Shabbat. Song, Halvai, we were going up there. Yeah? That's 700. We didn't even get there. Yeah? What does that mean? But it means all the songs. Yeah, you think the croissant gives life? He says, no. He says, right? He says, that's not what gives life. You know what gives life? The Torah gives life. Just like the Shamim gives life, the Torah gives life to human beings. And therefore, that's why he's comparing it together. But Rava Rava says, Yoter Shenitna Bo Torah. Rain is even better than the Torah. Likvi. What is the matar? The rain. What is likvi? The Torah. Umini tlebemi. Who's dependent upon me? Who? Right? Eveomer katan itlebagadol. So therefore, you're going to say that the katan, right, is going to be tole in the gadol. Yeah? Yaakov, do you walk with your son or your son walks with you?
I walk in my son.
No, yeah.
The katan
goes with you. Yeah. What is it? Meaning he's going with you. You're not going with him. Meaning somebody's gonna come and they're gonna say, this is my son, he's my father.
Just
guiding. 100%. Exactly. What does that mean? The katan is tole gadol, which means the smaller one comes first. You understand? Because I'm the smaller one, I'm being tole in the older one, in the greater one. So I'm going with the greater one, right? I'm not going to say that Rav Chaim Kanievsky is walking with me. I'm going to walk with Rav Chaim Kanievsky. You understand? That's just the way that it goes. Because the katan is going with the gadol. Not that the gadol is coming with the katan. So because of that, which one was greater? So he said the rain is even greater than matan Torah, because it said that the rain, right, yarok kamatan is lichi. So I want to remind you. By what we just said 2 seconds ago. We mentioned 2 seconds ago what was greater. Triatametim or Geshamim. And what did we answer? Triatametim. Right? But what did the Gemara answer? Geshamim. Thank you. Why the Geshamim is greater? No. You're in the next shot. Sadikim and Eshaim. So this is the same explanation. Says the Maharsha. The Maharsha asks Mordechai's question. And the Maharsha says, that here, what are we talking about? Exactly. Yeah. He's correct. I'm trying to give kavod to the Mordechai. Rabbi Mordechai. Right, so what happened? He comes and it's the exact same question. At the end of the day, you're going to tell me the Geshamim is greater than the Torah? So no. The Geshamim is greater than the Torah because just like before we said that the Geshamim was greater than Tchiyat HaMetim because Tchiyat HaMetim is for Tzadikim and the Geshamim was for Tzadikim and Rishamim. So to hear the Geshamim is greater than the Torah because the Geshamim is for Tzadikim and Rishayim, and the Torah is for Tzadikim because the Rishayim, if they don't know how to use the Torah, they don't know how to learn the Torah, for them, it's worthless. They don't understand it. It's true. It's 100% wrong. It's like Tchiyat HaMetim is wrong for them. But that's what they are understanding. Okay? That's what we just mentioned. Rabba Rami. Not Remi. Rami. Rabba, right? He cast the contradiction. Rami is like urmin, right? Like a contradiction. So Rabba, he comes and he asks the following question. Ketiv, it's written in the pasuk, Ya'arok k'matal lifi, which means that it's going to start raining. Uchtiv, it's written tizav katal minati, which means like this. Are you telling me now that the Torah is like matar, or the Torah is like tal? Is the Torah like geshem, or is the Torah like tal? One more time. Ya'arok k'matar lifi. Lifi is Torah. K'matar, like rain. Tizal katal imrati, right? It's going to flow like tal. Tal is dew. So one second. Is the Torah shave to geshem, or is the Torah shave to tal? Yeah. So the question is, which one? Im tamid chacham hagun hu katal. If it's a tamid chacham that he's fitting. So then, right, the hagun is proper, right? Proper. Then what happens, right? Like tal.
Yeah.
Vim lav, and if not, yeah? Or fehu kamatar. You're going to kill him, right? He's going to kill him like geshem. Okay, like the rain. Let's go. Yeah, so everyone, one more time. It's basically sometimes the Torah could act like matar, and sometimes the Torah could act like tal. Depends on you. Not on the Torah. Depends on you. Right? The Torah will, right, make you or break you. Right? Sounds like the way. Yeah? Fine. Tanya, we want to write down. Aya Rabbi Bena'a Omer. Rabbi Bena'a would say, I'm going to charge for it afterwards. Yeah? Anybody that's going to be Osek Batorah Lishma, anybody that learns Torah Lishma, Toratun Asal Lochak Sam Chayim. The Torah becomes for him a Sam Chayim. It revives you. It gives you life. It gives you strength. It gives you everything. That is the Torah. When you learn Torah Lishma, you get everything.
Like a medicine.
Like a medicine. Some. Right, Shneimar. Etz Chayim L'machazikim Kimba. Etz Chayim L'machazikim Ba. For the ones that come and they take the Torah, it's an Etz Chayim. For the ones that grab onto it, Ve'omen, and it says, Rikut Tehi L'Sharecha. It's going to be a Rekua Shneimar for your Taburecha. What is Taburecha? Your belly button, right? Taburo, which means that just like from the beginning of the creation, a child is being fed from his belly button. It's going from the, so he said, from the Hevel HaTambur, so to the Torah is Mezin Nafsho Shel Adam, right, until he becomes Shalem. That's Rifut. Rifut is Rifua. Tehil Sharecha. Ve'omer, and it says, Ki Motzi'im Atzachayim. The ones that look for me, they'll find life. Ve'chol Ha'osek Batorah Shelo Lishma. But if you learn Torah, which is not Lishma, a person could come and learn. Yeah? But they're not learning Lishma. Why? They're learning for different reasons. One person wants this thing, the other thing. He wants to become rabbi. Another one wants to become giving kavod. Other one wants to become a bigger, you know, different reasons. So what happens? Aselo sama mavet.
Whoa.
It becomes for him a sama mavet. You know what sama mavet is? Veneno. Huh? Veneno. No, veneno is Spanish. Huh? It becomes, right? It actually becomes poison. Yeah, it's poison. As it says in the Pasuk, Ya'arok kamata lifi, ve'en arifa ela hariga. Yeah, we know that arifa, which we just talked about, Ya'arok, right? Or right, eglarufa. Arifa hariga is hariga, killing. The Torah, yeah, the Torah speaks about it. So therefore, since we're talking about the Eglar Ufa, okay, and that's also in the Levinas as well. So therefore, right, we're talking about in the Torah and in the Gemara, Egla Arufa, La'aruf means to cut off the head, to behead.
Beheaded.
Now the Torah says like this. Amalei Rabbi Yirmiya le Rabbi Zera.
Exactly.
Amalei Rabbi Yirmiya le Rabbi Zera. And he started the shiur by saying we're doing double. So there's Rabbi Yirmiya Rabbi Zera. Leiti mor litne. Yeah, please, Rabbi, come teach us the Divrei Halacha. Teach us something. Yeah, you come, you ask. Teach us something. Amalei, he tells him, Chalash libai. I'm weak and I can't teach. Yeah? So fine. So he tells him. So they mamon milta dagata. Okay. I understand when you give halacha, halacha is, you know, it's very, very, you know, deep. Fine. So tell us a story. Tell us divrei agada. Divrei agada is, you know, story time. Right? Everybody can tell story time. Amale, so he said, Hachi amar Rabbi Yochanan. This is what Rabbi Yochanan said. My dichtiv, what does it mean in the pasuk? Ki Adam etz hasadeh. Yeah, Adam etz hasadeh. The human being is etz hasadeh. He's like a tree. Yeah, v'chi Adam etz hasadeh. He says, what? A human being is a tree? Now, what does that mean? Ela bara. Mishum divtiv, since it's written by the atzei apri, right? Ki mimenu tochel ve'oto lo tichlot. You're supposed to eat from the fruit of the tree. You're not supposed to cut down the tree. a fruit tree. No, 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 no. You're not supposed to cut down the fruit tree. You're not supposed to cut down the fruit tree. Right, we're not talking about Olah. We're not talking about what? Right, you're not supposed to come. Uchtiven, it's written, right? Ototashkid v'charata. It's written by a not fruit tree, from a barren tree, called in Hebrew Atzeh Serak. Serak means that it doesn't give fruit. It's written by Atzeh Serak, Ototashkid v'charata. You're going to destroy it, right? You're going to destroy it. Yeah, so he comes in such a case. So what's going on? Hakeitza. In Tamichacham Agun, Imenu Tochel, Ve'oto lo tichrot. If he's a Tamichacham Agun, so therefore, right? Lamem imenu. Learn from him. Don't cut him down. Learn from him. Eat his fruits. Take all the fruits that you can, and don't cut him down. Im lav, but if he's not a Agun, Oto Tashrit Ve'charat. What does that mean? Remove yourself from him. Don't mind. It all depends. Again, one more time, the same thing that we mentioned before about the Tamir Chacham, if he's a goon, so then it's going to be good for him, the Torah, Samachayim. If not, it's going to cut him down. The exact same thing. Which means that it all depends on the Tamir Chacham. 100%. Not only will you send your kids to school, right? Amar Abichama Berabi Chanina. Says Abichama Berabi Chanina. My dichtiv, what does it mean in the Pasuk? Right? Because again, since we're talking about the importance of learning Torah, right? We're going to learn about Dafka learning Torah as a Habura together. Kiyam Esechta, everybody here, not on Zoom, not on YouTube afterwards. Everybody in one place. You have to learn Torah together. Why? Because it's so important. So listen to this. My dichtiv, what does it mean in the Pasuk? Barzel be Barzel Yahal. Right, the ish yachad benirel. What does it mean by the zel zel yachad? When you want to sharpen, when you want to sharpen knives, what do? Anytime you take the two knives and use them against each other to sharpen, right? That's a right. Ashkazah. So too ish yachad benirel. Lomal lecha to tell you just like a barzel zeh. Echad lechad et chaviro. Each one they sharpen the other one. So too two tamidei chachamim. Right, that's how we talk. When people they learn together. They come and they sharpen each other with halacha. So you see how important this is to do with always learning in a group. There was a famous maharsha, but I don't remember now where it was. I think it's in Kiddushin on Shabbat. I have to check again. But I remember there's a famous maharsha that all of a sudden he writes down that he's not going to write any Kiddushin on this day. And they asked him, why not? And he writes it down, because I didn't learn it with my shiur. I didn't learn it with my group. But they had a group of people learning together. There's a special understanding. There's a zechuyot of everybody coming together. One asks the question, one answers, another one says another thing, the other one says this thing, right? One thing, another thing. And all of a sudden things become very, very clear. And then what happens is he says, that doesn't happen if you're by yourself. You can be very, very smart. But if you make a mistake by yourself, you won't get corrected. So nobody's there to correct you. So therefore, he didn't give up the shiur. Because now we're missing a daf of chidushim of the maharsha because of that. So they're very, very important. Okay? Let's do now chazara on everything that we just did today.